Find the inverse of the function f of x equals x squared plus 3 for x is greater than or equal to 0, and graph the function f and the inverse of f. Let's first find the inverse function. And the process to do that is to set the original function f of x equal to y. So y equals x squared plus 3. The next step for finding the inverse is to solve for x. So we'll subtract 3 from each side and say y minus 3 equals x squared. Now the step to get x by itself is to take the square root to undo that power of 2. And remember, when you take the square root, you have to take, say, plus or minus. So I'm going to write the result and say plus or minus the square root of y minus 3 equals x. But we are going to take away this minus, this negative sign, because we are told that x, we're only talking about this function where x is greater than or equal to 0. So if this x has to be greater than or equal to 0, then this side has to be greater than or equal to 0, or a non-negative. So I am going to get rid of this negative sign and just rewrite it one more time and say x equals the square root of y minus 3. Okay, and then that last step of finding the inverse is to swap x and y. So I'll just show that real quickly. Swap x and y, and then make the new y the inverse function. So I will just put that in a different color. The inverse of f equals the square root of x minus 3. Okay, so we've followed the directions. We found the inverse function. Now let's graph each of these. Now let's see, I've got the original function in yellow and the inverse in green, so I'll stay with that. I'm going to circle this inverse in green and then circle the function in yellow. Okay, the function, this parabola, x squared plus 3, it's going to have a vertex 3 units above the origin right here. And we're just looking at half of the parabola because we're looking at this this stipulation where x is greater than or equal to 0. So just up this way. So I'll just plot a couple of points to help me out here and follow that a little bit. And half of a parabola. Try to smooth it out a little. Okay, so we've got that half a parabola. Now, if you're wondering, hey, how do you graph that square root of x minus 3? Well, you could just plot points and find where that goes, but also let's talk about this idea that the inverse, the graph of the inverse, is actually going to be a reflection about this line, about this diagonal line, always. So if a function has an inverse, its graph will be a reflection about that line, and we can say the line y equals x. That's what this purple line is. So a reflection of this, well, with a little practice, you can see that. I think sometimes teachers try to act like it's really easy, but certainly we've practiced quite a bit on this, so don't get frustrated if you don't just get it right away. Okay, so that is the reflection of the original function. So we've graphed the function and its inverse.